Historical sources record that Prophet Ibrahim lived in Mesopotamia. The Quran informs us that he and his son, Prophet Ismail, peace be upon him, built the Kaaba. This confirms the historical accounts that Prophet Ibrahim did indeed live in the Middle East. At his time, nearly all of the tribes in the Middle East held pagan beliefs. They either worshiped statues made with their own hands, or else celestial bodies such as the sun and the moon. Indeed, historical and archaeological discoveries prove that this region was a pagan land. Archaeological excavations in the region have uncovered a great many remains of statues made from stone and clay and used as idols. Furthermore, in one of these digs, remains of the temples known as ziggurats were found. It has been proven with historical documents that the purpose behind these temples was to worship the sun and the moon. The tribe of Prophet Ibrahim were also involved in this great perversion. They made statues with their own hands and then mindlessly worshiped them. They prayed to them, and although it was obvious that they could receive nothing from them, they begged them for help. They even feared these pieces of wood and stone and hoped for assistance from them. God revealed to Prophet Ibrahim that he was the creator of everything in the universe and that those who believed otherwise were utterly mistaken. And he showed him proofs of his dominion over the heavens and earth. Because of that, we showed Ibrahim the dominions of the heavens and earth, so that he might be one of the people of certainty. Prophet Ibrahim explained God's existence to his tribe and called them to belief in him. The people of the tribe, however, refused to accept the truths he told them because they had sought refuge in the supposed justification of abiding by the religion of their forefathers. Yet it was obvious that abiding by the superstitious religions of their ancestors could benefit them nothing, but would rather inflict great troubles upon them. God has revealed the position of those who ignorantly abide by the religion of their forefathers in the Quran. When they are told, "Follow what God has sent down to you," they reply, "We are following what we found our fathers doing." What, even though their fathers did not understand a thing and were not guided?